thing. I'm quite obsessed with Game of Thrones at the moment. So I've just watched the episode that's coming up in 2 weeks this morning, like quietly from an HBO link on my laptop, and now I can't tell anyone about it. I know, it's absolute hell. I just want to talk to you, but I can't even talk to you about it. Anyway.
What is it that you love about Game of Thrones? Because it's hugely popular.
What I love is it's a genre that I've never, ever been involved with or been attracted to or ever given the time of day before. I don't like The Lord of the Rings. I don't like The Hobbit. I don't like anything like that. And I think that when I watched the first episode, it just kind of awakened something in me. This whole, like, fantasy world. You can get involved in fantasy worlds. Also, it's really expensive television. You know,
and do you think we should see more expensive television?
Well, of course we should. We should, you know, like anybody that can give us, like, you know, $5, $6, $10 million an episode, because you can see it. You can see it's all. I'm not saying that money makes the best television, but it certainly makes a type of television that's very, very watchable. So, you know, I'm loving Game of Thrones at the moment. But then, you know, the thing about being here tonight is that, you know, as somebody that writes about television, you're just seeing all the shows popping up and you're seeing these little clips and you're just remembering how much wonderful stuff that we make, you know, and I mean that absolutely sincerely. You know, you see it's coming up and you're kind of just going, oh, Parade's End, oh, The Town, I'd forgotten about this, you know, the Olympic ceremony, this is what we do, you know. There's just a lot to be quite emotional about tonight in the room.
And I suppose you're being on the writing side, you're often interviewing people, now us interviewing you about it. Where do you get started wanting to become a TV writer or writing about TV?
Well, I don't think that there's ever going to be a job in a job section that says wanted person to watch television and write about it to begin immediately. That's never going to happen. I think that you have to take a series of side steps to get into it. You kind of get into, you work out publications you want to work for and kind of just get your foot in there and then just work your way into writing about television. However, one of the main things to do is just write about telly and send it to people, because they're always going to need people. And, you know, you should also start a blog, you know, have your work out there. Because whenever you want a go and, you know, you're kind of stepping up and you want someone to give you a go, they're always going to say, well, show me what you've done. I always say that writing is, it's like the hobby, the pastime, the thing that you want to do with your life. That's the cheapest thing. You know, just the only thing that's stopping you is just you.
Yeah. What got you started, though? What made you so excited about writing?
What made me so excited about writing was it was the chance to get away from Cumbria, where I'm from. I love Cumbria. I love it. Please, you know, please don't kill me, you people. Love it. But I didn't want to stay in Carlisle. And the only thing that I knew that I could do was notice things that were happening and then write about them and make the mundane slightly funny. And I think that's all I've ever been able to do. And I really wanted to kind of get away, and I wanted to come to London. But when I was a little girl, I read Smash Hits, so I wanted to come to London and get off with pop stars.
And now that you are renowned and world known, do you do that? Has your dream come true?
Well, that's the thing. You do meet a lot more pop stars, but the fact is that, like, now I'm in my 30s. They're in their mid-50s, the ones that I wanted to get off with. So, you know, I probably could get off with them, but, you know, they're not in the, you know, it's like, but then I'd also inherit, like, 5 or 6 of their children, and they're, like, their divorce settlements. So as it stands at the moment, I'm still single.
Oh. But what is coming up next for you? Because, you know, you're a writer, we see you on TV. What's coming up?
What am I doing at the moment? I'm working on my next book, which is a memoir of, like, the last 15 years in media. What am I doing? I write my restaurant reviews, I write for the Evening Standard, and I write twice a week for the Independent, and I'm just having lots and lots of fun. I'm on Game of Thrones Thronecast right up until it ends, and then what am I going to do? I'm going to do my house up. At the moment, I'm working out what to do with my kitchen tiles in my kitchen, and that's as far as I've got. Haven't got any more plans.
Oh, brilliant.